One of the things that we've learned is if you wait too long to act, it can be very, very hard to bring something back. When I started in 1994, you know, the populations were healthy and you could go out at any time and see these things in the summer at the right time. And you could see literally hundreds of them. Now it's very difficult for me to go and see these sites and they're just gone. You could spend multiple days looking for them and not find them. I think there is hope for this species, but it's going to take a lot of dedicated effort by a number of individuals and organizations.
The Poweshiek skipperling is possibly the rarest butterfly in the world.
Starting in the early 2000s, we start seeing an almost total population crash of the species. And it's possible that this decline was happening longer than people realize, but that's when it really started becoming apparent that this once really abundant butterfly that we almost took for granted out on the prairies was no longer there.
We put a lot of thought into how it got to the brink of extinction. And the sad thing is, we don't know for sure. There's a general problem with insect decline. Poweshiek skipperling is just the poster child for how bad that decline can be. We worry a lot about habitat loss and habitat degradation.
If we go out in the fens where they remain in Michigan and we see more than five or six, that's a good survey for us. And that's really scary because that population level is just not sustainable for the species anymore. It's facing an extinction crisis right now. Captive breeding is a tool that we can use to increase the survival rate of a species that is otherwise really low.
That caterpillar looks great to me.
At the John Ball Zoo in Grand Rapids, Michigan, we're doing captive rearing and breeding, building off of what the Minnesota Zoo has really accomplished over the past 5 or 6 years.
Looks like a really good, healthy caterpillar.
Colored looks in the form.
Yeah. I have high hopes for that one.
This year has been by far the most successful that we have ever been working with the species. We're up to 17 breeding pairs in captivity now, which have laid over 1,450 eggs. We have a 90% hatch rate usually on those eggs. And so when you start to build up to those numbers, you can start to envision what that might look like for releases next year. You know, we're talking about now hundreds of butterflies that could potentially go out to these sites, which is more than's been on the landscape in years. These are eggs that have been collected from offspring from a female that was collected last year at a Michigan Nature Association property, and we've never been able to work with this population before. This is a really valuable lineage for us because we can cross them with many of the different individuals that we have been working with. Yeah, every one of these eggs is another potential Poweshiek skipperling that can get released in the wild or continue on in this insurance population we have.
There's multiple parts to managing for Poweshiek skipperling. One is having the individual butterflies to restore in new sites, but then the second is to have the foundation to release these butterflies into. That's where we also have to concentrate a big amount of effort.
You know, there are already so few places where the butterfly can survive. This is one of a very few places where Poweshiek were found last year. We've kind of watched over the past 20 years as they've winked out pretty much everywhere else, you know, even in places where they had more significant numbers before. You look at this and you can't see all the work that goes into it, but a lot of work does go into keeping it good for the Poweshiek. If we walked away and did nothing here, it could become not suitable Poweshiek habitat pretty quickly. I think it is our responsibility as stewards to keep this prairie fen what it is for one of the last remaining Poweshiek populations.
These fens definitely require management, in part because with settlement and other things over the last few centuries, we've seen historic alterations to their hydrology. An absence of fire, for instance, plays a role. We have these invasive plants that have gained a toehold in these areas and in some cases can expand quite rapidly within the fen. We make it a priority to go ahead and remove those invasive species and things like prescribed fire to mimic the historical fires that would move across the landscape. So these are, in today's world, a very management-dependent landscape. If we do a good job managing this population here and the habitat, we know that potentially they can recolonize other sites downstream. We still need to do more to understand these landscapes and understand each individual species, and ideally learn more about them before they become rare.
The plan for the recovery of this species is first and foremost to try to prevent the extinction of those remaining populations that still exist in Michigan. Taking these butterflies that we're raising here in captivity and getting them back out on the landscape. There she goes.
I was fortunate enough to grow up and be able to see this really special, unique butterfly and its little sparkling wings across the prairies. This was a part of our heritage that many of us might not have known was there, but it would be a shame to let this legacy go.
If this program hadn't started 2 years ago, we might not have anything to work with this year. And so being able to breed these consistently in captivity really gives this species a fighting chance. It gives it hope that we can continue to do larger and larger releases every year back in the wild. That's really how we start to change the trajectory of the species.
There are many times where I'm kept awake at night thinking about the fate of Poweshiek skipperling. On the one hand, I am anguished by the possibility of extinction, but at the same time, that motivates my efforts towards butterfly recovery, because we really are the last remaining hopes for this butterfly surviving on the face of the earth.